Hey, what's going on, everybody? Happy Friday. Welcome to another hot topic on He Say, She Say with your girl, CoCO J.
And none other than the hood, Howard Stern, representing from the D to the other D in the Rocky Mountains. You understand that?
I don't know why I laugh every time you say that.
I know, it's funny. That's why I say that shit every day. I say it all the time. Just because it's funny. But yeah, definitely representing from the D to the other D in the Rocky Mountains, man. Welcoming everybody back to another live episode of He Say, She Say, of course. And, you know, it's Social Media Friday. So if you got social media, you got to hit us up on Twitter and Instagram. So hit up my beautiful co-host, Miss CoCO J, at Hey, it's CoCO J. All right? Just like how you talk. Hey, it's CoCO J. And then, of course, me, Hood Howard Stern. That's going to be at Twitter and Instagram for both of us. So make sure you show us some love there. Also, if you got Facebook, you can check us out on there. www.facebook.com/he say she say. All right, so you can like our fan page. But it's been, you know, 7 days since the last time we've been in here. You know what I'm saying? It's been 7 days. A lot of things have transpired, but what's going on with you, Miss CoCO J?
Nothing too much. I've been chilling back and forth, visiting my uncle. He's still sick, so definitely still in my prayers, him and my aunt.
For sure.
But other than that, no. And it's like I never really have anything new going on.
It's not. I think with you is you don't like to tell nobody nothing. That which makes it for makes it bad for co-hosting because you be acting like you're not doing nothing. Then all of a sudden, you know what I'm saying? So if you want to continue to be an incognito, then you go right ahead, Dan.
I appreciate it. Thank you for your permission, baby.
No
but
problem.
Yeah, other than that, chilling with the kids. Not too much. Not too much.
Okay.
I mean, a lot, but not too much.
Right, not too much that you want to share. You can't be this private. Like, you can't be that private.
Well, you know, it's when things happen, you know, because most things are in the process of happening. So I don't like to talk about until, you know, it's a done deal. You know what I'm saying? So.
It's a radio show, though. That's what we do is talk.
I talk about it.
So you
know
can talk about those things.
But you know how they say burning bread. You don't want to burn bread on it.
Uh-huh.
Yeah,
don't count your eggs before they hatch and all that good stuff, right? Yeah, I know all the things.
I will say that I have another Zumba event coming up on the 1st of June. Mm-hmm. So it's more, you know, I'm going to be posting more information about it on my Instagram page and also on my Facebook page. But it's a health fair at a school in Detroit. So I'm looking forward to doing that because, you know, that's my passion. Dancing is my passion. And, of course, anyone who knows about Zumba is dancing, so.
Right.
Yeah, so I'm looking forward to that. I will say that. So that's another event.
And also, I mean, because I know this is the second event that we've been talking about in the previous month. So let people know how they can contact you if they have an event that they need Zumba instructors.
You know what? They can go. They can either email me NicoleJ805@yahoo.com.
Okay.
They can give me the information and we can just go back, communicate that way back and forth.
Okay.
And I do events, I do health fairs, I do fundraisers and whatever else. If you have any classes, you want me for a class or something like that. So, yeah.
Mm-hmm. Now, for people, because, you know, it's a different day and age. So for people who don't like to email, can hit you up on social media to try to get some information?
Yeah, they can hit me up on Instagram at Hey, it's CoCO J, and on Facebook, CoCO Flow. What is it? CoCO Flow Zumba.
I believe it's CoCO Flow Zumba. Yeah. So if you right, it's CoCO Flow Zumba or is it CoCO Flow? See, I can't remember. I think it's CoCO Flow Zumba. I'm pretty sure.
It's CoCO Flow Zumba.
Yeah, so you can go ahead and search that on Facebook if you want to contact her that way. Or you can hit up the email address, NicoleJ805@yahoo.com for more information. So that's what's up.
Yeah.
Because health fairs are important, man. I just want, first of all, I just want people to understand that. Health fairs are important. Just You know, just real quick, just to jump on that because we kind of mentioned it. Just watching the news a few moments ago, right? It was talking about the reporter from Detroit News who basically had a stroke because of high blood pressure. Didn't even realize that he had high blood pressure. And that's why health things like that are important, because it allows a person who wouldn't normally get checked out to just kind of like fall through and see what's going on with them.
Yeah, of course.
And it's a little better because I think some people, you know, some people who are on this radio show currently, you know, seem to be afraid of going to the doctor. So I ain't talking about nobody in particular, you know, just probably somebody on this show. But yeah, so for people like that, you know, give them an outlet to be able to just kind of, you know, roll through and get a little health check. So yeah, definitely. So that's what's up. So make sure you check her out. All right, if you got an event that you need some fitness, some Zumba instructor, you can hit her up at, again, that's NicoleJ805@yahoo.com. All right. But anyway, I'm sorry. Yeah, no doubt. So what was going on there? What else was going on there?
Nothing with me going on other than that.
Okay.
I'm in a process of, never mind. I'll keep that to myself for a minute. I may discuss it next week on the show. So other than that, nothing.
Just don't want to tell nothing. All right, it's cool. I understand.
Yeah, so what's been going on with you, Hood? How was Stern?
Man, I'm glad you asked.
I'm glad.
Just been doing the normal, like I say, just, you know, the everyday grind, trying to break out of the 9-to-5 grind. But, did the show, did my show yesterday, E-Block Radio yesterday, a pretty eventful topic. So if you missed that, make sure you check that out on replay at www.eblockradio.com, which you can find that and all of our other shows, of course, in the same place. But what I want to say real quick, man, is I know I don't want to give away no spoiler in case ain't nobody seen it, but dog, the underground season finale. I'm just saying, the underground season finale was phenomenal.
Oh, that was the finale?
Yeah, it was season finale, and then they said it wasn't coming back on until 2017.
Oh, you're gonna have a heart attack.
I'm pretty much so. So I it came on Wednesday, of course. We talked about it a little bit yesterday on the show. But, I can't really talk about it only because a lot of people like to binge watch, so they want to wait until everything over and watch the whole thing. So I kind of don't want to spoil it for people. But what I must say is that is a great story because of how it ended. But just to put you into the mindset, the ending was a perfect beginning for a new season. I just put it like that. The shit is good. So shout out to them again, of course, for John Legend for executive producing that joint, man. That's shout out to him and his production company who put that together. So that's what's up. But for sure. Outside of that, today is Friday the 13th. So if you are not paranoid, what's the word?
I have no idea what you're looking for.
Oh, man, me neither. I'm having a brain fart. Superstitious.
Oh, okay, there you go. All
right, if you are superstitious, then stay at home tonight because it's definitely Friday the 13th. It's nowhere near a full moon, though. I know it's been some Friday the 13th that have a full moon, and I think that strange shit actually did happen on those days. So I'm not superstitious.
I'm not either.
But the full moon combined with Friday the 13th, I'm going to stay in the crib and crack the Bible. I'm just saying. So anyway.
Well, nowadays, you got to stay in the crib anyway when it's not Friday the
13th. And crack the Bible.
Exactly. So right. The date Friday the 13th don't even mean nothing.
Speaking of which, I know it's Friday the 13th. I haven't really been checking out TV, but I'm super surprised if there's not like a bunch of marathons on with the Friday the 13th. I would be really surprised. Like, I'm going to check it out tonight, you know, after we get done with the show to see. But I'd actually like to see a few hats. Well, let me ask you this first.
Mm-hmm.
Have you seen or do you remember seeing the original Friday the 13th?
I think I have. It's been a minute, but that was the.
That's the original. That was like, what, 76 or something? Like, you know, yeah, in the 70s.
You know, I don't know. I can't say that I have, and I can't say that I haven't.
Right. Now, I think at some point, we probably all have seen it. You probably don't remember or not. But my thing is this. Like, we were so young. Obviously, you know, we wasn't even born when it really came out. But we were so young when they were kind of showing it, you know, where it was fairly new. Mm-hmm. All I'm saying is if you've seen that as a child, and then you grow into an adult and watch that shit, you will really see how terrible that movie was. Friday the 13th is the worst horror movie I've ever seen in life.
Oh, well, back in the day then, like you said, we probably thought it was...
Back in the day, it was the shit. Was,
exactly.
Yeah, back in... And what I mean by this, like, I think that we've become desensitized by violence, drugs, sex, you know, mm-hmm. drugs and sex mm-hmm. are always a part of horror movies. But in case you never noticed that. But yeah, it's funny because I think we've become so desensitized by it that when you see a horror movie that doesn't have a lot of that, then it's like it's the weakest shit ever. And what I mean by that is no lie. If you go back right now, it will probably blow your mind that there are no death scenes in Friday the 13th.
The original one is not?
No, you never actually see anyone die. No.
So what is
and there, it? And there's no blood. There is no blood in Friday the 13th.
So what is it, just the music that's...
It's the music, and then you see them coming with the knife, and then they show the dead body. Like, you don't see no actual killing. That's crazy, right? That's crazy.
Yes.
But when you think about the stuff that we look at now, then you look at that, you're like, what the hell? Like, why was we scared? Because now, they showing all of that. Like, they showing the gruesome, though. Like, they showing the knife going in, the blood,
everything.
Exactly. Well, let me ask you this. Do you think that's a bad thing? Like, is that overloading our senses?
By them showing everything now?
Yeah, exactly. Because you don't have to put your imagination to it.
I can only say for me that that's too much because I don't like seeing that kind of stuff anyway.
Yeah. Right, I see. Yeah,
they can sometimes go overboard with showing everything. They even on regular TV, they had a point on where they show everything.
So right, yeah, exactly.
Yeah, so
even on regular TV.
Even on regular TV, it don't have to be on cable no more. So,
right. Yeah.
So they can go overboard with it.
Yeah, it's kind of crazy though. But yeah, happy Friday the 13th though. But at some point though, if you're an adult at this point and you haven't watched Friday the 13th since you was a kid, please do me that favor and watch Friday the 13th again as an adult. Mm-hmm. And I guarantee you will be pissed off.
I'm not gonna say happy Friday the 13th because I'm not. Yeah.
You not what?
Happy Friday the 13th.
Yeah, you not what? Like what is it? What?
Exactly. Okay, so what is Friday the 13th? I mean,
it's
like
a movie.
I'm not talking about the movie.
It's a movie. What the hell?
It's not that funny. I'm not talking about the movie itself. I'm just saying, it's Friday the 13th. It's Friday the 13th. Like, what is it?
Well, you know, I honestly don't know. I mean, you probably got a...
Is it from the movie?
No, I doubt it.
I
don't know either, though, honestly. I can't give you an honest answer on that. But what I will say, though, is that I'm guessing that it's got... You know, 13 just ain't a good number. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, Friday the 13th, the 13th floor on buildings don't exist. Like, something unlucky about 13. Now, why they put it with Friday, I have no idea.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
I mean, you ever notice that, though? Like, everything, even like they got movies called, like, the 13th hour. You know, like, the 13th hour is worse than the 12th. You know what I'm saying? Like, I don't know.
No, I ain't never. They got a movie called that? I never heard of it.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
And then there's a saying, too, like, the 13th hour. Like, the 13th hour, for some reason, is like, you know, is you too late kind of thing. Like, that's the reference. Like, it's too late.
Oh.
Yeah.
Okay.
Right. Yeah, but I don't know. and honestly, what I'm going to do real quick is I'm going to get ready to Google it because I want to know.
I'm already.
Sorry, y'all. Okay.
But until then, we can go move right ahead.
Yeah, because it's supposed to be like the unluckiest day on, you know, but I don't know why.
Right. Yeah, I'm not superstitious like that, so.
Yeah, I mean, because that's what it is. It's superstition, but.
Yeah, that's all that is.
Yeah. I don't know. I'm trying to look at it. I know. I kind of want to know that. Now I'm curious.
No, I was going to say, we both can't do it. Then
no, I'm not.
Quietness.
I'm not doing it. I'm moving right along. Yeah, I'm moving right along.
Okay.
What I want to talk about, too, real quick before we get into our actual topic, is I got to say something about the new law that they're trying to pass. It hasn't been passed yet, I don't believe, but it's been presented. And this is basically for transgender students in public schools, I believe, in public schools, that they have the right to go to the restroom that they identify with, and it doesn't have to be the sex that they were born. Now, my thing is, first of all, I don't think the law got nothing to do with that. I don't think it should be no legalities to that.
Mm.
But the very first, the pre-first thing, then, let me say the pre-first. So before I can even say that, I think it's the dumbest shit ever. Okay, all right, let me take that back. I won't say dumbest because I, you know what, the dumbest shit ever that you allow a child to change their gender. Now, if that child is a boy and he thinks he want to be a girl, then let that little boy be gay. Because if I'm not, well, transgender means you actually change genders, right? Like they cutting his penis off and forming a vagina, right? Am I wrong on that?
In a process, yeah.
In a process.
Getting all the hormones, right. And all that stuff, yeah.
Why would you allow a child to do that? Why would you, like, if this child can't buy cigarettes, vote, or go to war, he can make a decision whether he wants a penis or a vagina?
But
I don't think so. I don't think so.
Is it legal for, for kids that age to even have that kind of surgery, or do they have to wait until they're older to do the actual surgery? You know what I'm saying?
I mean, if they haven't had no surgery, then they not transgender, are they? I maybe I'm confused. I don't know.
I don't know how that goes. You can get the hormone shots, I believe, like shots and things of that nature.
So you can still have a male reproductive organ.
But I think you have to wait. I'm not, I can't really speak on it. I'm not sure. It seemed like it would be an age to where you have to be a certain age to have the actual surgery to change.
Okay, so this is like a, okay, so this is just a basically a mindset. So physically, you're still a boy. I'm gonna need you to take your ass to the boys' bathroom. We're not even about to have this confusing ass shit in a school.
Yeah,
you know what? If you wanna make this an issue in public area restrooms for adults, then possibly. You know what I'm saying? For an adult in a public place, then possibly. First, this shit ain't no legal issue. If you think you a girl and you a boy, go take your ass in there and piss like a boy. If you still have a penis, I'm gonna need you to stand at the urinal. I don't want there to be no confusion. I don't want you to be transgender going into the, because these are kids. This is what I'm saying. These are kids. So I don't want you to be transgender going into the little girl's bathroom and the little girl's wonder why you always standing up and pissing.
Right.
Seriously, though. I know that we're supposed to be getting our kids and the next generation prepared for what the world is, but at 10, I don't want my little girl coming home asking what's the gender neutral name? Why Robbie stands up and piss all the time. Like, Daddy, how come I can't stand up and piss? Now I got to have this damn conversation on top of everything else. Well, Robbie's different.
Right.
Come on,
yeah,
dog.
Yeah.
and I'll tune in to Black Terror. Get Merc Records in the building. My nigga forensic. Yeah, I'm moving. Beat slow key. Don't mess with me. Y'all rappers better pack a lunch. Glad y'all mad, my bad, I'm hot. Cold trash, so sad, but man, I'm not. Cause I got some knots in my pocket, jeans. Took it up a notch, not profit green. Thought they said money don't fall between.
Witness the Black Tie Experience. Black Tie Photography, servicing all of Metro Atlanta area. My name is Cedric Pitts, your photographer. Check out our website at www.blacktiepictures.com or like our Facebook page, facebook.com/blacktiepictures. Let me capture your professionalism in class, and you will have the ultimate black tie experience.
What car drop? My car drop?
All right, we worked out our technical difficulties here. It looks like we had some issues at the station with some calls going in and out. But yeah, so we back. And no, CoCo J, what happened was we were kind of in a conference call with everything, and then one of the calls dropped. So just give you an explanation on that. Yeah, you got me. All right. So we're going to jump off into the topic then. And today's topic, of course, as I mentioned before we went to break, we're trying to see what should you expect when dating someone with kids. Like, so what should your expectations be? All right, so if you're on eblockradio.com right now, you can hit us up 760-283-4647 and hit that number one key. We want to know, what should you expect when dating someone with kids? So, CoCo J, what you say, man? What are the expectations that you should have in this situation?
You know what? First, I would have to say it all starts off, it all depends on the relationship. I mean, if you're with this person to be with this person, then of course it's expected, you know, it's expected for you to be expected for you to accept those kids, whether it's the woman or the dude who has them or both. And when you're in a relationship or you're beginning, you just started dating someone, and you are aware that that person have kids. You have to ask yourself, do you want to date this person with kids? Do you want to date anyone with kids at all? Because if you don't, then you need to step off.
Right.
But if you continue on dating, then you eventually, you know, you're going to meet the kids. And, you know, it's not you going to be taking over the daddy role or anything, you know, it's just, you have to, you know, it's like, it's expected for you to accept those kids. This is the way you're taking care of looking out for your, you know, the person you're dating, you know, you expected to do the same with the kids.
Right.
As well. So in the beginning stages, you know, you're just getting to know the person you're dating, then you meet the kids and getting to know them, and then you just, you know, slowly but for surely, you kind of step in. We ain't, like I said, ain't playing daddy role or mama role. Now, you may be playing daddy role or mama role if the other parent is not in the picture at all.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? But,
right.
So you're gonna have to definitely be ready for that. Yeah. And if you ain't,
To a certain degree, even if the other parent is, you know, in the situation, to a certain degree, there is still, I believe, some sort of expectation.
Oh, most definitely.
Okay.
Most definitely.
Yeah.
Most definitely. Okay. Most definitely.
Okay.
So you can't be in this relationship with this woman or with this man and expect not to have a relationship with their kids, because that's definitely, well, with me, it will become an issue.
Right.
So you got to have a relationship with my kids as well, that bond with my kids.
Mm-hmm. And just to keep it real and put things in perspective, I think we had one of those situations early on, right?
Oh,
where, yeah, I mean, you know, we keep it 100. It's all radio show, right? So
yeah,
we had that situation early on where, you know, where I think the expectations.
I was about to dump you.
Right, basically.
Yeah.
So just to put things into perspective for those out in radio land, basically what happened was, you know, this was at the beginning of our relationship, and, of course, you know, at this point, she has kids and I don't, but I guess my interaction, now, I'll say this, my expectation wasn't wrong. I just didn't know how to go about the interaction with children. So anybody who knows me knows that I'm probably not the most definitely not the best communicator with children. All right, so I threw that off of it. So you know, this nearly presented a problem at the beginning of our relationship. So with that in mind, I think the expectation is that in order to be in this woman's life, or you know, vice versa if it's the other way around, then you have to explore that, you know, that relationship that you have to have with the children, whether it's the man or the woman.
Right.
Now, this is imperative if you really want, you know, things to work out. Now, if we're talking about, you know, the beginning stages, I mean, I think this goes back to what you were saying. It just kind of depends on what that relationship is about to be. So,
right.
Now, this is important, though, and I have to say this. This is definitely important, and I have to say this because there's so many women who I think do this prematurely, all right? So this is definitely an issue where you have to know where this relationship is going. And what I mean by prematurely is that there's a lot of women who have, you know, dudes around their kids that's not necessarily nobody. Like,
exactly.
This relationship not headed nowhere.
Exactly.
Right. And then
and
it makes it look bad because now it's like a rotating thing, and now you're setting a bad example. It leads
exactly.
into a lot of things.
Exactly. Yeah. And that's what is that saying to your kids? Every dude that you date, not in a relationship with, but date, you introduce them to your kids, they see them coming out the bedroom or some shit like that. So
exactly.
that's just disrespectful.
Right.
Yes.
And this is bad on many levels. So I know a lot of people look at it and think that, you know, yeah, especially if she has a daughter, but no. Because
no,
even if she has a son,
exactly.
there's still an issue. So
Yeah, most definitely.
Yeah, so women I think, let me see. I guess just to kind of break it down. Women who have kids and they dating somebody who doesn't, I think that your expectation while dating someone should, first of all, should not be set immediately. Like, your expectations for what that person should do with you, with your kids, should not be set, you know, initially. I think that expectation can't be set until you are conclusive in exactly what this is about to be.
Right. Exactly.
Now, for the other way around, we'll just use the man and woman thing. So we'll keep it this way currently. So for a dude going in dating a woman with kids, I think your expectations, quite honestly, can be set initially, because at this point you have to realize that, I guess for lack of a better term, or what we used to say back in the day, is a package deal, right? So when you date the woman, you dating the, you know, you taking the kids too, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah,
so
that's true.
Package deal kind of thing.
Yeah.
So that expectation can be set, and you need to have that expectation set so that you don't waste too much time while she's trying to figure out if she needs to set her expectations. You get what I'm saying?
Yeah. And, make
sense?
And like,
okay.
Yeah. And like I said, it all depends, and it all boils down to, once again, I always say this, communication. You have to communicate. You got to be straight up with one another. You know what I'm saying? If you two just started out dating, or you courting this woman or whatever, and you know, and you are aware that they, you know, you have kids, both of you have kids, and one of you may have kids or something. I mean, you have to know what their expectations are. And if it's not right. what you want, you got to say it. You know what I'm
right.
saying? Because it's, yeah. because you just lean that other person on. Now, if it's just about the sex thing and you don't want to get in a relationship and you don't really want to deal with nobody, have, you know, be in a relationship with anyone who have kids and you just want it just sex, okay, right. still communicate that. Let that person know. Because then
yeah.
that will give that person the choice on whether they want to do it or not, make, you know, whether they want to deal with that or not. So you
right.
definitely got to – it's all about the communication. And now further on into courting or dating and you seeing that, you know, y'all vibing and y'all been dating for a while,
mm-hmm.
and it is official. I'm going to say, let's say when it do become official,
okay.
you still have to communicate. And sometimes you shouldn't – you still have to communicate it, but at the same time, it should be expected. Does that make sense?
Yeah,
so it should be kind of expected because y'all are in a relationship now.
Right.
I'm not even talking about buying material things for the kids or anything. I'm talking about just having that connection with them when you're around. You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
Kicking it
right.
with them.
Right.
You know, and some people, women and men, some people feel like when they're in a relationship with that person who have kids, they don't want to step on a mom or the dad toes. But at some point, I don't think it's about stepping on a mom or dad toes at all.
Wait a second, on certain things, right? And as I mentioned to you before, I know that you will never understand this because you have a vagina and not testicles. All right, so this is the one thing that you'll never understand. So for the single fathers out there, y'all go feel me on this. If certain things that when a father is, even if it's not 100%, if a father is somewhat in that child's life, there's certain things that you want that young man to be able to share with his father.
Okay.
I mean, for one thing, all right, like
uh-huh.
one thing, especially if it's a young kid, is sex. That's something that,
oh, yeah.
that he may want to, I want, you want to give that man's father at least a chance to do that. Other things, like tying a tie. I think to me is one of those things. And as a single father, I would be a little disheartened if I didn't get the opportunity. Now, if I just blew the opportunity to teach you how to tie a tie or, you know, do these type of things, then that's my fault. But if I was never even given the opportunity, you know, like then I would feel some kind of way. So those things I think is, you know, a little bit different.
I said certain things.
Okay, so just like for a mother, let's say that this is my daughter, and now we're together, and you know, little Quincetta.
Where did that name come from?
She getting on age, and she needs a training bra. I would think that I want to give her mama the opportunity to do that first.
Oh yeah,
you know what
I'm saying? And I totally agree. Like I said,
so those kind of things. Yeah.
But I'm saying, as far as kicking with them in that relationship, and you know,
yeah.
just getting to know that kid or
right.
those kids,
right?
How many, you know, however many that person may have.
Uh-huh.
But yeah, it's definitely a communication thing between the adults, and then it's a communication with the kids as well that you have to keep open.
Right.
And so that should be expected. That should definitely be expected because it's a turnoff. Because I like I said, with you, when we ran into that issue, I was like, nah, this ain't going to work.
All right.
And, I was about ready to dump you.
Yeah, I know, you know. We discussed that. We discussed that.
But that just lets you know that is important. You know, that's important. That's very important. And it should be important to a woman or a man who have kids and this person is around your kids.
Right.
And it's also expected, you know, when you're in a relationship with the person who have kids, it's also expected for you to respect their relationship as well. Say, for example, my kids, me and my kids,
Okay.
And we do our thing. This is how we've been doing it. Or vice versa. Dude and his kids, and they do their thing, and you step in, you try to change everything. You know what I'm saying? Sometimes that's how it goes. I ain't going to say all the time, but sometimes, you know, people try to change things up or how people do things because they feel that since they're in a picture now, this is how it's going to go. I've seen that happen a few times, so that's why I brought that up. And so you got to respect that relationship as well with the mom and kids and the dad and the kids, how they, you know, they outings. If they do outings, and I think this happens a lot when a woman is dating a man with kids and she don't have any kids.
Okay.
And this woman wants all this attention, but you have to understand that this man have kids he needs to spend time with. You know what I'm saying? Right. So that's what
I
mean.
I see what you're saying.
Respecting the relationship.
Yeah, okay, I get it.
Because a lot of people, some people can be selfish. They don't care if you do have kids. You know, then you just see them last week.
It happens.
That's a sign that this woman or this man is not for you.
Hey, damn, did you just have your kids,
girl? Right. So yeah, and if you ain't ready, if you're not ready to handle, take that responsibility on.
2 years in a row?
If you're not ready to take that responsibility as a man or as a woman dating someone who have kids, then you need to not step to that person at all. Because this is it's a position. It comes with it when you're dating someone within a relationship. You have a responsibility. Now, if you just playing around and playing games, let that be known. Like, baby, look, you pretty. I want to spend some time. I want to kick it with you every now and then. But I ain't ready. You know, I ain't ready to, you know, go take you and the kids out to dinner or nothing.
What happens in those situations, though, where it is presented that way? But the woman really feel like you a good dude. Like, I need you in this situation. What happens then? What's the compromise then if you've been told that, though, up front? Like,
no,
hey, I'm cool on all these kids. Like, shit, I'm cool. Like,
no,
we can kick it.
It's no compromise. That's not compromise.
Oh, come on now. Just saying women do it all the time, though.
Yeah, they do it, but they're forcing something that's already been told. They're forcing it. Why forcing it? That's just going to make it worse. If this gentleman or this woman have told you that she ain't ready for all this, but y'all can kick it and hang out sometimes.
Man.
But I'm just saying.
I hear what you're saying. I'm just saying that there's probably more women out there that do that than you think.
And I'm sure it is.
There's probably a lot of relationships that aren't for it. And they end up lasting a long time. She'll probably be married for 60 years. But
if a man tell me that, I'm going to back off. I ain't going to. He not here. I'm sorry. If a man tell me that, that's good enough for me.
I mean, I'm
going to leave it alone.
You're going to leave them all. Don't forget, if you're on eBlock Radio right now, eBlockRadio.com, you can hit us up, 760-283-4647. We want to know, what should you expect when dating someone with kids? Now, what would you say is a different expectation when, you know, when both parties have kids? Like, what is the set expectation on that?
When both people have kids, to set expectations.
Because you both, I guess, if you use the theory that we used previously, then you both kind of waited out to see if this is what we want to do. So once you get to that point, then what is the expectation then? Like, are we supposed to make this, you know, one big happy family? How do we do it? You know, I guess it's a blended family. Is that what they call it?
Yeah, I mean, eventually, I can only, you know, this is my opinion. Eventually, I would want to, you know, be one big happy family, marriage, and all that kind of stuff. Because that's an expectation. Because it's like after a certain age, if you're dating somebody with kids, or both of y'all have kids, and y'all always being together, hanging out together, then. And so are the kids hanging out together, being together all the time. I mean, what that's the next step to me. Those are the expectations. I'm not doing this just to say, okay, I date a dude with it, or I date a dude with a kid, or kids, and that just be it. Boyfriend, girlfriend for 5 years and with kids, no. So I'm just saying that would be my expectation. One big happy blended family.
Okay.
I'm just saying, because it's like after a certain amount of time, that's who you mainly spend your time with, especially if you two have kids.
Would you say this? This is it's probably a tough one to answer, but in this situation, and 'cause I'm just thinking, I'm thinking about all the situations that I know. You know, just thinking of some blended family situations and a couple of the homies in situations like that where they got a kid and then they you know, they new girlfriend or wife or whatever has a child, and then you know they put the kids together, and I think. From my viewpoint, from looking at, you know, the homies that I got, for them, I think it was actually a little easier, because this is a bad thing. This is a good thing and a bad thing all wrapped in one. It's a good thing because it was easier, but it was only easy because the father wasn't in the picture anyway. You know what I'm saying? So it made it easier to put that together because that child basically needed a father anyway.
Right.
Now, when in those situations where the father is present, I think it changes that dynamic a small bit. But my question is, though, I think with that dynamic, there are a lot of missing fathers. Doesn't that make the blended family scenario a lot tougher for the women? Because a lot tougher for the women, because when you got this dude with a kid, you know that mama somewhere. But with me, with you, there's a possibility that this daddy ain't gonna never be nowhere to be found. Like, he don't want to be found. No, seriously though, all jokes aside. Seriously though, right? But as a woman, you gonna have to deal with his mama.
Yeah, and you have to.
So don't you think that y'all have it a little tougher because of that?
You know, like, it all depends on the mentality that you have.
Yeah.
So I ain't gonna say tougher. You just gotta be a grown. You gotta be a grown ass woman, and at some point you're gonna have to communicate with the mother of the child, or the and if the father is in the child, you're gonna have to communicate with the father of the child, especially if it's something that's a long term relationship and it's, you know, y'all talking about taking the next step or whatever. It's about how you, yeah. It's you got to be grown up about the situation. Now, if you just immature and ignorant as hell, that is what's going to make it tough. You know what I'm saying? And if you see that parent, the mother or the father is ignorant as hell, you're still going to have to try to communicate. And then you will be like, you know what? I'm not dealing with it. Not with the mom or the dad, but.
Yeah.
You still just have to, you know, it's basically about the mentality that you have.
Yeah.
So.
Right. And then before we get out of here, just listening to this conversation and then listening to your response there, I did have just one other thing. And this is on the subject, but it's kind of like this. I mean, it's on the subject, but a little bit off. Do you think, just kind of piggybacking on that about how you said, you know, basically acting like an adult, right? You know, acting like you got some sense pretty much. Now, do you think that when you had those situations like, quote-unquote, crazy baby mama or crazy, you know, baby daddy, do you think that those people are really like that? Or do you think this is a result of people purely not understanding how to cultivate relationships, period? Because I think that some of these people not genuinely like that. They just never learned how to deal with relationships.
It can be both. It can be either. It can be one or the other. It can be both.
Right.
So it could be that they don't know how to handle relationships, deal with relationships when conflict come about. And it could be that they just ignorant as hell. I'm just saying.
Could just be that.
So if you're that ignorant, you're not willing. If you're that ignorant, you're not willing or want to learn how to, you know,
How to resolve conflict.
How to resolve conflict and when it comes to relationships. So it can be one or the other, or it can be both.
All right, well, we're gonna wrap it up because we only got like a couple minutes left. So we're going to go around one last time. So just to get back on the topic and close it out, what should you expect when dating someone with kids?
You should expect for that person to be involved not only with you but in your kids, have a relationship with your with those children, vibe with those children, communicate with those kids. It should be expected for you to, you know, it's fine if you to buy kids things, Christmas or just whatever, or you know, and then it's expected for you to, you know, just like I say, step up to the plate as not as their dad, but as their role model, because you are a male in their life other than their dad. If their dad is in the picture, you are
right.
Still expected to be this role model because they're seeing you often. Every day,
right.
Probably, if you come around, if you come to the house every day, so it's expected for you to uphold, you know, it's expected for you to be that role model. So, and then, and the expectations, if the relationship goes on longer, the expectations is probably not going to stay the same,
right.
You know, because things, people change. And things in relationship change. So
right, situations change, right.
Yeah. So you got to be ready for it. And like I said, if you ain't ready for it, do not date anyone with kids. Simple as that. If it's a
right.
hit it and quit it thing, make that no. Communicate. So communication is definitely expected in a relationship when it comes to having, when it comes to kids.
Right. I would definitely, yeah, I agree with that. And then just to also add to that, you know, just to close out the show, of course, what you should expect when dating someone with kids. As a person who doesn't have a child, what you should expect with dating someone with kids is that you are about, you know, if you're going into to that realm of relationship, you are about to be, you know, become a part of that family. No matter what role you're playing, if it's a father figure, a mother figure, a role model, what have you. You do have to understand that you are applying for a role, a position in that family. Now, on the converse side of that, or the flip side of that, also as a person with kids, dating someone who does not, that expectation needs to be set. That I mean, the same expectation should be set, but also your expectation does have to be crafted in a way, or I guess we'll. Is crafted a good word, or customized, I guess.
Mm-hmm,
so I say customized in the understanding that this is not, I mean, and this is what we dealt with in the beginning, all right? So you had to customize your way of thinking to understand that even though that expectation is there, the reality of it is that someone without that experience is not going to be able to catch on immediately. So,
tell me about
just saying.
It.
So, and that's going to happen. As long as that, like you said, communication is key.
Yeah.
Once that happens and those expectations are straightened out, and then you realize, you know, where your position is and what your position needs to be moving forward, then at that point, the expectations are already set. So, you know, hopefully you should be good to go.
Yeah,
my love, man. We're about to get up out of here, man. I want to thank everybody who checked us out today on eblockradio.com. Everybody that called in today, don't forget, if you checked in late, you can hear the whole show on the replay at www.eblockradio.com. And make sure that you follow us on Twitter and Instagram at Hey It's Coco J and Hood Howard Stern. But until next week, enjoy the rest of your Friday the 13th. And
have a safe and blessed weekend.
For sure, man. It's your boy, the Hood Howard Stern, Q Lewis, holding it down from the D to the other D in the Rocky Mountains.
And your girl, CoCo J. Peace.
Peace out, y'all.